CBS Sports welcomes you.
Fox Sports welcomes you.
NBC Sports, celebrating 15 seasons of Sunday Night Football, welcomes you.
ESPN welcomes you.
Welcome to the following presentation of the National Football League on NFL Network.
Before every game and at the end, they tell you it's a presentation, which means whatever narrative you see week by week is a narrative they control for the purposes of entertainment. Just like this video I put together, I control the narrative in which you see what I want you to know. So let's strip away money, lights, camera, and fame, and look at this from a spiritual perspective.
There's two archetypes in the game of football. There's the warrior, and then there's the company man. The warrior does not see this as a business. He doesn't see it as a game. He is emotionally invested in the violence, the stress, the anxiety, the passion. He sees this game as an act of war. The company man puts the team, the owners, and the league before his own image. He uses the shield as what it is to be a national football player. When he goes to work, clocks in, he's able to go home and not take work with him. The warrior takes his work home with him. He cannot separate field from off field. The company man goes to all the charity events. He puts on the smile. He puts on the blazer. He does everything the company wants him to be. He is the representation of the shield. Now, I want you to keep this in mind when we go through this interview and dissecting Booger McFarland's comments.
Gotta get to work. That's right.
Yes.
Come on. My name is Willie.
Baby,
I keep the ladies
creaming
and all my fans.
But mark this, there will be terrible times in the last days. People will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, proud, abusive, disobedient to their parents, ungrateful, unholy, without love, unforgiving, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, not lovers of the good, treacherous, rash, conceited, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power. Have nothing to do with such people.
Now, I've seen this too many times. Played in the NFL almost a decade. You played a long time. We've been around it for a long time. And oftentimes young players, especially, and I'm going to go here, especially young African-American players, because they make up 70% of this league.
Now, what he's about to do is what they do to all African-American players, current or ex, when it comes to talking about the issues of other African-American players. They've done this before. When you remember Willie Lynch papers, in order to control the slaves, you had them fight amongst each other. Hair texture, color, shade, height. In this example, you have the older slave getting ready to reprimand the younger slave, which causes a rift between our communities or our nation about his comments and addressing Dwayne Haskins.
They come into this league and they ask themselves the wrong thing. They come into the league saying not, how can I be a better player? They don't say, how can I be a better teammate? They don't say, how can I be a better person? How can I get my organization over the hump? Here's what they come in saying. They come in saying, how can I build my brand better? How can I build my social media following better? How can I work out on Instagram and show everybody that I'm ready to go, but when I get to the game, I don't perform?
Hi, I'm Frankie Thompson, the best-dressed assistant locker room manager in the league. I'm here to help you protect your clothes from getting damaged in the wash. Nah, that's why I use new Downy Defy. It helps stop stretching, fading, and fuzzing. What's up?
We have an assistant locker room.
When young players come into this league, they see who's on TV the most. And what is the behavior they see? Clowns and effeminate behavior. So as impatient is, so as impatient does. And young kids get wrapped up in marketing themselves more than playing. Every skill position goes through this phase. It's not psychological, but spiritual. We, the sons of the true living God, unbeknownst to us, were recycling the sins and curses of our forefathers, thinking we are the first to worship flesh and idolatry. The flavor of this league is to pimp these athletes like whores into secret societies. Cam has been underperforming since 2016, but the redundant cheetah print sex beta programming and black and white Masonic colors is getting no Vaseline prostate exams whenever Freemasons want to use him to get black masculinity to swallow that eunuch pill and call it Black Boy Joy.
Is going with zebra stripes instead of a panther theme on his trip to the Super Bowl, as you see a video of him walking along. The Panthers arrived to San Francisco Bay, the area, yesterday. Newton created quite the buzz wearing those print jeans, the black and white striped pants with an intricate gold pattern from hip to ankle.
I'm Brian Arakpo.
We play football together for the Titans.
Now, we own a cupcake shop. We bake, we decorate. I love this new Surface Pro. It's light, it's sleek, it's fast.
I'm able to draw what color frosting we want. We deal a lot with social media.
We have funny videos that we do in the bakery. There's nothing that you can't do on this device. Cupcakes are a great business.
Oh yeah, as long as you don't eat the profits.
Tom Brady, J.J. Watt, and his brothers, the Bosas, and Peyton Manning have never done commercials where they were effeminate. All of their commercials have been hyper-masculine or masculine. They never baked cupcakes and wore pink. They never wore a tutu, and they never damn sure didn't wear cheetah print.
Dwayne Haskins, unfortunately, is not the first case that I've seen like this.
Yes.
It won't be the last. And it bothers me because a lot of it is the young African-American player. They come in, and they don't take this as a business. It is still a game to them.
Look at it as football.
This ain't football, right, man. This is a billion-dollar business.
Yes.
It's billions of dollars. They pay us a lot of money to talk about the game. So imagine what they pay these guys to play the game.
Yes. Yeah.
They play a child's game and get paid a king's ransom. And it bothers me because I saw a quarterback do it. I saw Jamarcus Russell do it. The number one pick in the draft, they gave him $40 million and he threw it down the damn drain because he didn't take it seriously. And it bothers me because there ain't a lot of jobs like this around.
Mm-mm.
I'm going to tell you, I've been retired a while. It's not a lot of jobs like that around where they will pay you millions of dollars for virtually 6 months of performance. So my message to Dwayne Haskins, not just him, but the rest of the young players in the NFL, man, this is a game, but take it as a business. There are billions with a B of dollars at stake. And until you start approaching this game that way, until you start coming to work saying, you know what? What can I do to get better today? What can I do to make sure my teammates are better today? How can I put my organization first instead of my damn Instagram?
And it's hilarious to watch Randy Moss sit over there and just shake his head like he was the company man all this time. Chris Carter had to baby him. They had to hold his hand for him to stop emotionally moping around and come to practice. This was a time that he didn't come to practice or wanted to play. They literally had to treat him like a child to get him to want to play football. Now he's sitting across that desk like he's been a company man all his life. Let's step back for a bit. The people who run the entertainment industry, music, sports, and Hollywood, know exactly what they're doing to the African-American community, Shemites, Israelites. And whether you know it or not, that's who you are. You're not Moors, you're not Pharaohs, you're not Egyptians, and you're not Hamites. You are Shemites. So they know exactly what to do to keep you laden with sins, is to keep promoting promiscuity, whorish behavior, and clownness. So this is just a byproduct of what they're doing. Those people that are sitting on there listening to this whole spiel, even Jewish Adam Schefter, he's in a religion looking at the true children, trying to shake his head in agreement with them when he knows exactly what it's supposed to do to our people, which is keep us dumbed down and keep us at a low degree and keep us in sin and not waking up to the true identity of who we are. So this whole argument of Dwayne Haskins is a problem because of social media, no, the whole thing is the problem, and they want it to keep going on and on, and they're just using this sellout coon to say, oh, it's his fault that he didn't get his life right, or it's his fault they want to be on social media, when this whole entire world is to keep you dumbed down like Dwayne Haskins.
Take it as a serious business, but too many times, it's a game. We want to TikTok. We want to do all these different things. Man, do you understand how much money is at stake?
The brand is about being professional before you become a brand. The brand is about winning.
But one must not forget the most important thing in the nigga fight game. Mm-hmm. And that is a nigga that can win fights. Mm-hmm. Now that should be your first, second, third, fourth, and fifth concern. Now after you have that, and you know you have that, then you can start to implement a grand design.
You win, you're professional, those other things come along.
They don't see it that way, though, Shefty. These young players don't see it that way. And Randy, it bothers me. And it's not just young black players. But this league is made up of majority black players. And so you see a lot of young players who come into wealth, who come into fame. They want everything that the NFL can give them. But they don't want to give the NFL nothing.
And like I said before in the earlier part of this video, he is a company man. So you're going to give you company logic. It's the shield before the player. It's the team before the player. It's the image of the owners before the player. When you are a warrior, you don't care about owners. You don't care about their children. You don't care about the league. You care about what you need to do from week to week to week. You don't care about how much money you're going to be making, your incentives, how many yards you need. I didn't go into the game looking, I need 5 or 10 yards to break records. I need 5 or 10 yards to get $100,000. I didn't look at that. I looked at you if I can cripple you or not, and that's how I played. And I always played that way, so I don't ever look at it as a business. So when I left the game and I had cognitive issues, company men don't deal with those issues. Warriors deal with cognitive issues, emotional issues. A lot of players, they don't want to say it though, a lot of players are suffering emotionally because they were warrior players, that they didn't leave the game on the field. They took it home with them and they still take it home with them, and they have to live with the byproduct of playing in this game. And I'm going to say this too. I don't regret playing the National Football League. I don't regret playing football ever. If I had to do it again, I would do it again and do it harder than I did it the first time. But it led me here to find Yah. And what I'm saying in this whole scheme of things, that he looks at it as, it's about the shield. It's about the game. And when you know what happens when you leave the game, you know what happens when you leave the business don't look out for you. You have to continue show receipts that you are getting help. You have to continually fight for your reimbursements that you got from playing in the league. You have to continually fight for your money once you leave it, because you have personal or emotional or physical trauma. You've seen the movie Concussion. So what is he talking about? That no one wants to do things for the league. You're not there to do things for the shield. You're there to play and play as best you can do and get out and help you can be healthy when you leave it.
Man, this game is a hard, hard game. And so Dwayne Haskins, it's a sad example. Hopefully he learns from it.
I hope he does. Yeah.
I don't have confidence that he will, but hopefully he does, because I've seen this cycle before.
We never had these in-depth panel discussions when it talks about the inequality of black players wanting to be black assistant coaches wanting to be black head coaches, and black head coaches wanting to be in front office. We never had these in-depth conversations of the National Football League inequality and inability to hire more black players or black people in general. But we will have in-panel conversations talking about an African-American male named Booger talking down that he doesn't have any confidence in a young African-American player. And we keep spinning this cycle until you wake up and understand what stronghold you are facing right now.
When you're on company grounds or part of a company, you can't speak truths that are in direct violation of company beliefs. To understand what you can't say, follow who owns the company, who profits from the lies instituted by the owner, and go a little further. Who do these owners worship? When he posted who the real Israelites are, they might as well told my guy.
Not on my property. Not around my niggas, he can't.
What do you see? A stadium, right? What do you see? An ancient stadium. What is Rome in the Bible? Idumea. Edom. This country is their stronghold with the help of Ashkenazi's children. We are merely gladiators, warriors, playing a script, a narrative. Remember when Caesar put together quote-unquote games where a side was supposed to lose?
My history's a little hazy, Cassius. But shouldn't the barbarians lose the Battle of Carthage?
6 years, Stephen. How many niggas you think you see come and go, huh? 7,000? 8,000? 9,000? 9,999? Every single word that came out of Calvin Candace's mouth was nothing but horseshit. But he was right about one thing. I am that one nigga in 10,000.
And the house of Jacob shall be a fire, and the house of Joseph a flame, and the house of Esau for stubble, and they shall kindle in them and devour them, and there shall not be any remaining of the house of Esau, for Yahuwah has spoken it.
He's the guy who's the talk of the town with the wrestling.